on her way.
She is, yes. I haven't seen her yet.
What an absolutely ecstatic movie.
Sorry.
What an ecstatic movie.
Oh,
okay, I'll ask a couple of questions and then we'll open it up. When is the soundtrack coming out?
I think because the film will open first in Europe in December, I think it will come out in early January.
And the incidental music is your new band, Squirrel?
Squirrel, we performed, Josef Van Vissen kind of created the score with his lute pieces, and then Squirrel played with him on some of those pieces as variations, and then we made some pieces separately.
How long have you been thinking about making a vampire movie?
Well, I'd say eight or 10 years. And I had an early script of something similar to this about 7 years ago, and was not able to get anything financed on several tries. And then sort of put it aside and made another film on The Limits of Control. And then came back to it, rewrote it, started again, and it finally happened.
You know, I have a very particular read on this movie. It is incredibly romantic. It is incredibly glamorous. It is very, very, very funny. And it is a comedy because it resolves in their favor. But it reminds me so much of a certain memory of, not the real thing, of downtown New York in the late 70s. And I wondered the degree to which, when I said, how long have you been thinking about this, I wondered the degree to which that filtered into it.
Well, I'm not conscious of that at all. I mean, it's certainly in it's sort of a period where I kind of developed aesthetically and started making films and music, so I'm sure there's something of it in me and in this film, but I'm not, it's the first time I ever thought of it. I don't know, it's not a conscious thing.
Amy, we have Tilda here.
Beautiful sitting here than she is in person.
I'm Amy Talbot. Yes. All right, ready for a question. The movie has an incredible tone that's sustained by all the actors and which is very delicately balanced and never falls into trap. And I wondered how Jim communicated that to you, or how you all came about sustaining that.
Well, the first thing I would say is few, because we did wonder, did we not? I think we all just threw ourselves off the precipice as usual and kept, you know, Jim is our baseline, there he is all the time, reassuring us that this is how it has to be, and we just, as reasonable and intelligent people, trusted him. But it felt that we didn't necessarily know until this moment, I mean, that it didn't dissolve into camp or whatever. It was just a romantic risk that we were all willing to take, Jim included, I would say. We wanted to make a kind of atmosphere that we hadn't seen before, for sure, but when you haven't seen something before, you don't necessarily know how to make it. So you just kind of grope around in the dark. And if you're groping around in the dark with your friends, it's always better than groping around in the dark by yourself.
Did you play musical, Mister? No. Okay. All right.
No, we did circulate music to the current
Michael.
We didn't play music on the set while working, but we did circulate a kind of mixed tape to the cast and crew.
And the film is about, on its base level, a couple that has lived through a lot, and their relationship sustains them and makes them, in the end, want to continue to live by any means possible, which is why it's comedy. But how did you make, again, it's still, how did you make the coupleness of it? Because you seemed like you had lived together forever.
That's another very nice thing to hear. It is, as you say, about surviving things in general, life in general, but being together in love. You know, when a long relationship, this one, of course, many hundreds of years, sometimes all our relationships feel like they've been many hundreds of years, even if they haven't been. Just rebooting one's connection, rebooting the reasons to not get out a gun or get really depressed and sit in your underpants all day and do nothing else. Just that feeling of being there in support. That was something that Jim and Tom and I talked about for a long time before we started shooting. And we were all so clear that what we wanted was a couple who really felt familiar. Familiar in the way that you do long after you've first been fancying each other and, you know, just end up in bed for a long time. People who have really, really talked constantly about everything. You know, she says at one point, you love telling me stuff about all the fancy people you used to know. You know, that's one of those things she's learned to put up with and love as well. We talked about all of that. We talked about the texture of a really, really long friendship. And we also noticed that we hadn't necessarily seen that in the film, a man and a woman who obviously really fancied each other still, but really, really loved talking to each other as well. So we kind of, you know, cut that off by the yard and laid it down.
One thing just about the DP. Had you ever worked with him before?
No, Yorick Lasso. I had not, although Tilda had worked with Yorick maybe three times before. And I was first, because of the nature of the production, I had to use a director of photography from Germany or Europe, of which there are many incredible ones. So it was a bit complicated. But Tilda had highly recommended Yorick. I had seen his work. I had talked with a lot of different directors of photography, but I felt really comfortable after meeting him several times. And I also spoke at length with Olivier Assayas, director whose work I love, who had worked with Yuri on a number of films. So, and then meeting him was just fantastic. So I knew he's sort of the closest approach to a film of anyone I've worked with besides Robbie Newell, in a way. And so he has a very similar approach that Robbie has.
This film, I'm just curious, was really lit. I mean, it was lit.